Welcome, welcome, welcome to episode 24 of Street Sense with me, Maxwell Mensah. You can call me Talent Man. On this episode, I'm going to share with you 7 types of ladies who will definitely cheat on you. 7 types of ladies who will definitely cheat on you. When I shared this episode, I knew people were going to fight me, and they really fought me. The guys really came at me. And so this is a follow-up for the guys as well to know the types of ladies who would definitely cheat on them. But let me issue a disclaimer. Yesterday's episode and today's episode is not to incite you to go and be suspicious of your guy or of your lady. No. I'm not trying to incite you to go and be suspecting your guy. I suspect you're a cheat. I suspect you cheated before. I suspect you. No. That's not the essence of what I'm doing. It is just to let you know that so that when a person is showing these signs, you know how to play your cards. You know what to expect, or you know what is going on, or you know how to handle him or her. And so on this episode, I'm going to share with you 7 types of ladies who would definitely cheat on you. Look, I have been cheated on before, and it was a very unpleasant thing I went through. It was a very unpleasant thing. You know, I have seen so many people who have been cheated on before, whether it's guys or ladies. And it is a very sad thing. I never knew it could happen to me, but it happened to me once. And it wasn't nice. You can see my smile is even gone. It wasn't nice, Charlie. It wasn't nice. But don't worry, I won't share my experience. It is not about me sharing my experience. It's about you being mindful and knowing what to expect and the signs that gives them away. But before I get into it, I want to remind you, kindly subscribe to my channel now. If you haven't subscribed, I don't know what to say to you, but kindly subscribe now, like this video, leave a comment for me, and share the video so that other people can also learn what you have been learning on my channel so far. Let me remind you, as I keep saying, I'm on a 100 days YouTube challenge. A 100 days YouTube challenge. And today is day 24. And my goal is to get my first 1,000 subs by the 100th day. And so if you haven't subscribed and you've watched up to this point, look for the subscribe button now. Just look for it right now and subscribe now so you can help me achieve my goal. 7 types of ladies who would definitely cheat on you. The first lady who will cheat on you is the lady who never appreciates what you do for her. A lady who never appreciates what you do for her will definitely cheat on you, or is most likely to cheat on you. No matter what you do for her, she's just not satisfied. She's just not satisfied. She's just not satisfied. She said, you do things for her and she feels like, well, you're my boyfriend, so it's your responsibility to do it. So, why should I appreciate you for it? You're my husband, you've done it for me. So why should I appreciate you? You bought me a new phone. So why should I appreciate you? You changed my car for me. And so, like, do I have to thank you for changing my car for me? Isn't it your job as my husband or as my boyfriend? Don't you have sex with me? If you do this for me, and so, today you cooked supper, and so I should carry you on my head. Today you did this nice thing for me, so if I just say thank you, is that not it? Why should I appreciate you beyond that? I mean, if a lady doesn't appreciate you, she's a suspect. She can easily cheat on you. Either she has cheated before or she will cheat on you. It's in her. The next type of lady who will cheat on you is the lady who needs or who keeps asking for more than you give her. No matter what you give her, she wants more. No matter what you give her. So she asked for an iPhone 12 Pro Max and you got her an iPhone 11 and she's angry. Is that what I asked for? I asked for an iPhone 12. You got me an iPhone 11. I mean, who is using iPhone 11 these days? And she's angry. If she does that, she has the signs of someone who will cheat on you, or she has already cheated on you. She's doing that because she sees other guys who are able to do more for their girlfriends, or who are even able to do more for her. So why is it that you, her boyfriend, or you, her husband, you are unable to do same as other guys? And so you realize that she thinks you can do more than you're doing. So, I mean, why are you giving me this when you can give me more? I mean, it's been a whole month and you're just giving me 500 CDs. I mean, as for being your girlfriend, you're just giving me 500 CDs. Like, for real? For real? Why can't you do 2,000 CDs? Meanwhile, she doesn't consider the fact that even the 500 CDs you gave her, it came out of a place of lack. You didn't really have much. But, I mean, in a way of showing her you love her, you just decided to give her this amount of money just for her to just do anything she wants to do with. A lady who always asks for more than you give her, and she's never appreciative of what you do for her, is someone who has either cheated on you or is likely to cheat on you. The next type of lady is the lady who is still very close to her ex. Just as any guy who is so close with his ex is likely to cheat on you or has cheated on you before. A lady who is still so close to the ex will most likely cheat on you. She will most likely cheat on you. The thing is, she has to be friends with the ex. That one there, see, if you're a guy who is preventing your lady from being friends with the ex, you are being too possessive. I mean, like, for real. You are being too possessive. Definitely, she has to still be friends with the ex. Unless probably the ex did something that's unpardonable or unforgivable. So that one day you prevent her from being friends with the ex. That's a different case altogether. Besides that, allow her to be friends with the ex. Allow her to be friends with the ex. But you, the lady, you can't be too close to your ex than you are to your boyfriend. The person is your ex, so, and you are dating now. But every time, or let's say every week, you are still hanging out with your ex. Every month, just say you, every month, you have a day in a month where you hang out with that ex. Are you kidding me right now? Are you kidding me? No, it shouldn't be so. It can't be so. It shouldn't be so. He is your ex for a reason. Cut ties with him. Don't cut ties off completely. But Charlie, be mindful about the friendship you keep with your ex. So, my guy, if your lady is still so close to the ex, especially if they had sex when they were dating, Charlie, be concerned. Be concerned. I'm not saying I'm going to be too suspicious. I'm going to be suspecting her of cheating. No. But if she's still so close to her ex than she is with you, or even equally, or even very suspectingly, something could be going on. So if a lady is so close with her ex, it could be someone who would definitely cheat on you. The next type of lady who may cheat on you or who can definitely cheat on you is the lady who does not or who needs too much attention. A lady who needs too much attention. Just say, you can spend the whole day with her, but she still wants you there again. Just say, she wishes that you will be there with her all the time. You know, there are ladies like that. I have met ladies who are like that. Even just as friends, they are friend though, but they wish you can be there. I mean, they wish you can give them more attention, like more than usual attention. Yes, your guy needs to give you attention. And my guy, you need to give your lady attention. You need to give her attention. But if she wants to give her attention beyond what you can do, she said, even when you're in the office, you're in the office, but she wants to be chatting with her throughout the day. Even when you're busy, be chatting with her. Chat with her, but it shouldn't be beyond or too much that it interferes with other things you have to do. The moment your lady needs too much attention than you can give her or than you are able to give because of your work and other things you do, it could be a sign that she is someone who wants to cheat or who can cheat. Because the moment you are unable to give her the attention she needs, she will look elsewhere. The moment you are unable to be there for her for some few minutes, some few hours, she will look for another guy who will be there for her. So if she needs so much attention, she is a suspect. It is different when you, the guy, you know you're not giving her attention. You know, just like you are the busiest guy ever. So you, 24 hours, you are busy. 24 hours, you are working. 24 hours, you are in church. 24 hours, you are occupied. So you are unable to give her attention. That one there, you are giving her away. You are giving her the chance to go and cheat on you. That one, don't come and blame me or don't come and blame her. You are the one giving her the chance to go and cheat because you made yourself busybody. You are so busy with work. You are so busy with running your company. You are so busy with church. You are so busy with other things and you are unable to give her time. That one there, you are not giving her attention. So when she cheats, you caused it. But if you are giving her enough attention, but she still wants more than what you are giving. She wants more. She says she wishes that after the 24 hours in a day, you'll be with her for 20 hours. It's not possible. It is not possible. Unless you're on vacation, that one, they're fine. But if you have to work, you have to, you have church work to do, you have other things to do, and she needs you more than usual, she's somebody who can cheat on you because the moment you are unable to give her your attention, she will start looking elsewhere. The next person, a lady who brags. A lady who nags. She is most likely to cheat on you. She is most likely to cheat on you. A lady who nags. She's nagging because she feels there's more you can do than you're doing. She feels that she feels inadequate. She feels that you are. I don't know how to give this one. A lady who nags, whether there is a reason to nag or not, she will nag. And if you meet a lady who nags, you will know. She nags about everything and anything. What you do and what you don't do, she will nag. A lady who is nagging too much is a suspected cheat. I won't go further. Next, a lady who has too many male friends is most likely to cheat. A lady who has too many male friends. Look, Charlie, have male friends, so my lady, have male friends. Don't cut your male friends off because you're dating. It's wrong. It is wrong. So have male friends. Just as your guy to have female friends. So yes, have male friends. But don't have too many male friends where it looks like you're the lady, you don't even, you can't even count five ladies around you who are your friends. All your friends are male friends. All your friends are male friends. Are they? Are they? And I know ladies like that who have so many male friends. I mean, it's cool. It's cool. But the moment you start dating, have a boundary. Have a boundary. They are your male friends, yes, but have a boundary. Let them know that, look, Charlie, the time I used to spend with you, the eyes I used to spend with you hanging out and vibing and chilling and all that, now I'm dating. I can't give you the same time I used to give you. So I can only give you my time when I'm free, when there's nothing really to do with my boyfriend. When I'm really free, then I can give you my time. Now it is my boyfriend I need to focus on. So we can chat once in a while, we can vibe once in a while, but I'm dating. But if your lady has so many male friends and she still wants to be so close to her male friends, even though you are with her, she's a suspected cheat. She can easily cheat on you. Easily cheat on you. The last type of lady who would definitely cheat on you is a lady who listens to her friends more than she listens to you, especially when her friends are toxic friends. She is most likely to cheat on you. Most likely. If she listens to her friends more than she listens to you, she will most likely cheat on you. Most likely. The reason is that her friends will give her advice that is most likely to be contrary to what you advise her on. Most likely. So probably she has met, you are dating her, but then she has made a new friend, a new male friend who is showing interest in her or who is showing signs that he wants to move her. And then she tells her female friends. If her friends are toxic friends, they'll advise her, give him a chance. And they may end up poisoning her mind against you. And she will end up cheating on you. And so if she listens to her friends when she listens to you, it is a clear sign she is most likely to cheat on you. Now let me give you a bonus one. If your lady has no self-control, she is most likely to cheat on you. She is most likely. Or let me say, she will definitely cheat on you. If she has no self-control, she will cheat on you. You know, a man or a woman without self-control is like a house without walls or without a door. Anyone or anything can enter and come out at any time. So you, the man, you need self-control so you don't cheat. The lady you are dating, if she doesn't have self-control, she will most likely cheat on you. Because without a self-control, she's like a house, a very nice house that doesn't have doors, that doesn't have security. And so the house is very nice, but there's no door, there's no security. Anyone can walk in. So be careful if a lady has no self-control. She will most likely cheat on you. Thank you very much for staying through with me on this episode of Street Sense. I'll come back with more content. Make sure you subscribe to my channel. Make sure you like this video. Make sure you comment. And make sure you share this video. My name is Maxwell Mensah. Thank you very much.